Hey everybody, it's Eric over at Breakthrough Broker. Super excited. Wow, we had over 800 people registered to learn how to increase your average sales price. Again, my name is Eric Sachs, co-founder over at Breakthrough Broker. Excited to be starting a fresh new set of webinars for 2020. Today, we have one of my dear friends, Michael LaFido. Michael is one of the foremost luxury brokers in the country, and he's gonna talk to you a little bit about his background. We're gonna talk today about increasing your average sales price, and so some housekeeping items. Yes, this is being recorded, so you don't have to ask. We're going to send it out this afternoon. It is being recorded. I show right now that our audio is good and we tested the audio. So if you're having audio problems, if you're having any audio issues, please check your internet connections to make sure, close all your browsers except for the webinar, and we'll be ready to rock and roll. Also, I want to remind everybody, we're going to start doing at the beginning of every webinar, we're going to remind everybody about different features on Breakthrough Broker. I want to remind everybody today that Breakthrough Broker does have a direct mail marketing platform. So when you're ready to send just listed, just sold, price reduced, coming soon postcards out, you can create a farm within Breakthrough Broker. You can purchase a prospecting list or upload your own. And if ordered before 1 o'clock Central Time, it's one of the only direct mail platforms in the country that will send it out same day. So you can get stuff out same day. So Michael, welcome. So excited to have you. Michael and I just spent several days together in New York City at Inman Connect, and I'm so impressed by some of the stuff that he's doing. And he just sent me a package about of how he markets his properties. And oh my gosh, I can't wait to see my team. So Michael, welcome. I'm going to make you a presenter, and we're ready to rock and roll, I believe. So we should see your screen.
Yeah, let me know when you can see it.
I think I see it. We see it now.
All right, perfect, perfect. So we want to provide amazing content here for the next about 40 minutes here, Eric, and then we'll open it up for some Q&A. So if any of the guests want to type in questions as we go, save those to the end. But if you're anything like me, please type them in now because you might forget. So chances are I might cover some of the questions they have. But let's get right into things. So you guys are definitely in the right place if you're looking to increase your average sale price over the next 90 days in 2020. Again, thinking back to 2019, I'd like you to think about how many homes you sold. I'd like you to think of your average sale price and keep that in mind as we go through the training today. So again, if you're looking to differentiate yourself, if you're looking for a wide open niche, if you're open to new marketing strategies, and you want higher commission checks, you're in the right place for today's training. It's not a bunch of theories. There's a lot of trainers that have been there, done that, but they're not in the trenches today, overcoming objections today, dealing with iBuyers, dealing with, you know, disruptors, all the things that you and I are going through. This is what makes, you know, me as a trainer a little bit different, as I do practice what I preach. I'm based in the Chicagoland market. I run a luxury consulting company, but I also run a luxury team. But if you're looking for the magic pill or some magical website, this is not the right training for you because they don't exist. But I can tell you there's a lot of things that add up. It's kind of the compound effect that will help differentiate yourself, will help attract more opportunities for you with high net worth clients and luxury buyers and luxury sellers. So a lot of fresh new approaches, some creative outside the box ideas we're going to be talking about today. Just like you, I'm an agent. I'm a father of three. I've written a lot of books, have podcasts, and we practice what we preach, but we're always looking to get better. There's an old adage, iron sharpens iron. So we're always looking to get better, learn new strategies. Just like Eric had mentioned, we were both at the Inman event last week in New York. We're always looking to learn new strategies, new, you know, best practices, et cetera. And we bring those to you, our audience members. I don't know if you do a lot of driving based in Chicago. We're in a lot of traffic out here, but if you listen to podcasts while you're working out, that sort of thing, we do have a podcast. It's called Luxury Listing Specialist. It's on iTunes and Stitcher. We just released our 76th episode. We bring in other luxury agents. We share best practices. And we are releasing one podcast a month starting in 2020. So we're up to our 76th podcast. My story, real quick, don't want to bore you with details, but I do think it's a little important to get some context of who I am and my background. I didn't come from a real estate family or a real estate brokerage or, I came from a blue collar background. I was a former high school health and physical education teacher. Eric, I got a 19 on my ACT, and as bad as that is, I got an 18 the second time. And the reason I share that with you is there, I'm not one of these brokers that, came up through a family and upbringing where the parents handed down the book of business, or I'm not in a luxury market like the East Coast or the West Coast. I'm in the Chicagoland market. We have anywhere from 6 years of inventory or more in some cases, of $1 million plus properties. So it's definitely what you call a buyer's market. With that being said, in a buyer's market, you can't do the same things as everybody else. You can't just be reactive and throw it on the MLS. You have to be aggressive, and that's what we're going to be talking about. My first 5 years in the business, again, I was a full-time teacher and a part-time real estate agent, and I looked at as real estate, if I could make, 8 to 10 grand a year, that'd be the equivalency of coaching a couple sports. My first listing ever, Eric, was in this condo building. It was an $80,000 one-bedroom condo. I went from selling entry properties and starter properties like this to some amazing properties. The middle property is the Empire House. It's on the TV show Empire. Architectural Digest named this the most beautiful home for sale. This property on the far right, I brought in $2.5 million worth of vehicles for the photo shoot and the video shoot. We do seminars and trainings across the country. This is a client of ours. We're selling the Nashville mansion. Although I'm only licensed in Illinois, we can co-market all across the world. We took our class through this $15 million mansion. So let's talk about why you're here. Why you're here is to increase your average sale price over the next 90 days. And I believe there's three ways you can do that: to increase your average sale price, increase your commission checks over the next 90 days. And we're gonna talk about those in depth today. Number one is solid foundation. Number two is your marketing blueprint. And number three is the positioning power. How do you attract versus chase, right? There's two forms of marketing. There's cold marketing, which is prospecting and chasing leads. And then there's warm marketing, which is attraction-based marketing through your database, your sphere, referrals, et cetera. So we're gonna talk about ways you can do that with luxury clients. Again, a lot of case studies. I did a training down in Nashville, and Ed Andrews, one of his agents, about doubled his listing price just through our strategies. So let's get right into the solid foundation. The solid foundation, by the way, this is an image of that Empire Mansion, that home I'm selling in Barrington Hills, Illinois. It's currently on for $9.5 million. That house, or this house, or the house you live in, if it was built on a weak foundation, what happens? There's some crumbling, there's some settling. The fixture shift, maybe the floorboard shift. If a home is built on a poor foundation, there's a lot of bad things that can happen. Well, no different than your business. Breakthrough Broker provides amazing tools and resources for agents and team leaders and et cetera. Having the tools and the resources is important. You got to build a solid foundation. And so I tell agents all the time, when you have more knowledge, you'll have more confidence. When you have more confidence, you'll have less fear and you'll step out of your comfort zone. So when you grow your knowledge, your confidence will grow. When you have more confidence, Eric, what's going to happen is agents might do some lead generation or some prospecting outside of their comfort zone. Last year, when I was at that Inman conference that we were just at in New York, Eric, I had an agent come up to me from Atlanta. Somebody introduced them to me and shared what I do and something about our designation. And she said, "Man, I wish I would have met you a few months ago." She said, "I had the opportunity to go on a $10 million listing appointment in Atlanta. It was a PGA golfer's home. It was pretty much a for sure thing that I was going to get the listing because it was a recommendation, a referral. And I didn't go on that appointment because of fear and limiting beliefs. And what if they ask me how many have I sold in this area? What if they ask me what's my highest sale price? The what ifs. And so I'm here to tell you, if you gain more knowledge, you'll have more confidence and you'll have less fear. So some of the ways you can gain more knowledge is being on trainings like this, today's webinar, going to events. There's a lot of free white papers and reports out there from all types of brands. You need to be a student. You're always learning, always learning. I don't care if you're with Keller Williams, you can learn from Coldwell Banker. I don't care if you're with Coldwell Banker, you can learn from Century 21 or from a boutique. there's some great content out there. NAR put some great content out there, but be a student of the game and you'll grow your knowledge. When you grow your knowledge, your confidence will grow. Finish this with me. Garbage in, garbage
out.
Garbage out.
Everyone's muted. We would have had 400 people yelling at you.
We're at 400 people yelling at me, garbage out. And that's what most people say, Eric. It was a little bit of a trick question. Unfortunately, I believe garbage in, garbage stays. Think about it. The media, the doom and gloom, constant negative news, CNN, constant negative news, or impeach this, impeach that. It's all negative. It's negative. It's negative. And so if you consistently feed your brain with negativity, then naturally that's what's going to happen. We actually just released, I have a vlog, and we just released a new educational video today talking just about this concept, your environment. Who do you surround yourself with? Okay, you're the average of the five people you spend the most time with. Zig Ziglar once said, you hang out with nine dead broke people, you're bound to be the 10th. I believe if you hang out with nine top producers, nine overachievers, you're bound to be the 10th. So unfortunately, garbage in, garbage stays. When we're talking about building that foundation, strengthening the foundation, Eric, we're talking about mindset. We're talking about environment. We're talking about who you're surrounding yourself with. What are you feeding your brain? Your brain is a muscle. Just like if you were to break your leg skiing and you had it in a hard cast, atrophy occurs. That's when the muscles shrink because they're not being used. So you need to consistently be feeding your brain and your environment with positive thoughts, as opposed to the negative Nancys or negative Nicks in your office that are always complaining, oh, my broker didn't do this, the coffee's cold, oh, this, you know, they have a grass is greener mentality and they're always negative. You got to get rid of those people. They're cancerous. Lisa Hayes said it better than I did. She says, be careful how you talk to yourself, because guess what? You are listening. And so many times you'll hear sports teams, you know, they'll talk about how they, David versus Goliath, how did this team, you know, beat this team? You know, and so it's not just sports. It's you and I. It's as a father, as a husband, as teaching our kids this. Adults, we need to be reminded that you have to talk to yourself in a positive way. Whether you think 2020 is going to be your best year ever or not, you're right. Okay, so you have to believe that even if the market's terrible, even if you had a couple, you know, strikeouts in a row and you're a baseball player, you got to think, if I'm going to get a hit the next at bat. I went on 9 luxury listing appointments. I failed all 9. That 10th one I'm going to get. You have to think positively and you got to surround yourself with that kind of mindset. So how do you talk to yourself? Only you can answer that. Tony Robbins says success leaves clues. Go figure out what someone else that is successful at something and model it, tweak it, and make it your own and improve it. And that's what I'm hopefully going to give you today is a luxury blueprint, a blueprint to increase your average sale price over the next 90 days. Now, Eric, you and I have talked about what is luxury, because luxury is all relative. You know, I firmly believe if any agent looks back at their sales in 2019, homes they represented, whether it be a buyer or a seller, chances are 80 to 90% of those transactions would fall into one of these four buckets, price point buckets, if you will. You have entry level pricing or starter homes for your given market. It's different in every market. You have average price homes for your given market. You have high-end homes for your given market, which we defined high-end homes as 2 times the average sale price of your given market. So if the average sale price, I did this training in Kokomo, Indiana, it was an Explode conference, and the average sale price there was $80,000. I never had been to a market where that average sale price was that low. So the average sale price was 80. So high-end pricing would be, like in that case, 80 times to 160. 160 to 240 would be high-end pricing. Why 240? Because we define luxury home prices as 3 times the average sale price. Now, there's a lot of brands out there that define luxury by default as $1 million and above. And I had this gal from the Kokomo training come up to me and say, I'm so glad I come to your training today. I came to your training because guess what? We don't have many $1 million plus properties. And I was hesitant to come because I thought the message wouldn't resonate, but we certainly have a lot of 150s and 200s, and we have 400 and 500 thousand, just not a lot of the 800s, the 900s, 100,000 or the million plus. So I believe one of the ways is that you can increase your average sale price is add more high-end and luxury properties to your portfolio. Does that make sense?
Yep.
So if I were to look at the homes you represent, let's just say in 2019, you sold 20 houses. For somebody on this training right now, and fill in the blank, you should know how many homes you sold, and you should put those homes that you sold into these four buckets. Like I said, not pictured out of these buckets, by the way, not pictured would be rentals, bank owns, and maybe Uber luxury on the far right. But again, 80 to 90% of sales fall into these buckets. So if I were to look at it like a pie chart, look at your 2019 sales, and let's just say for this example, you sold 20 homes in 2019, and 9 were in the entry level, this gray area, about 45%, which equaled, you know, if you take 9 homes and let's just say 100,000 on average, that'd be about 900K in sales volume. That price point would be above that. For this example, we're saying 250 is the average sale price for that given market. So 250,000, if you sold 7 of them, 7 times 250 is about 1.75 million. And then let's say you sold 4 high-end homes. Okay, 4 out of the 20 you sold, so 20% of the homes you sold were high-end. That's about 2 million in volume. Add up all the volume, and you know, then that gives you an average sale price of around 230. Well, if you were to fast forward a little bit, Eric, and let's just say 12 months, 24 months, maybe somebody's an overachiever in this group, and 6 to 9 months, or maybe 3 months down the road, if you could shift the average sale price of homes you represent by adding more in some of these buckets down here, high end and luxury, you can make more money selling the same number of homes. We call that working smarter, not harder. And that's the goal I have from this training. If anybody that listens to our podcast or other webinars or go through one of our luxury trainings, we did 34 of them last year, is to work smarter, not harder. And again, just like if one of your listeners won a $5 million lotto ticket, your financial advisor, Eric, would tell you, diversify your portfolio, have some low risk, some high risk, some long-term investments, some short-term, have some liquid cash. They would tell you to diversify your portfolio. And I'm here to tell you that same thing. Most agents don't break into selling high-end and luxury, Eric, because it takes longer to sell or might be more marketing dollars. And that might be true in most markets. That's why we're telling you to diversify. But I believe the fastest way for an agent to get instant credibility from their database, from their sphere, from people that know them, like them, and trust them, for people that don't like them and trust them, Eric, is for an agent to land that first high-end or trophy listing in their given market. As I mentioned earlier, I'm in the Chicagoland market, and I think the greatest athlete of my time is Michael Jordan. Michael Jordan's home has been on the market for over 7 years in the Chicagoland market. It's in a town called Highland Park. It's over 7 years. There was an agent that was co-listing it from Beverly Hills. I won't mention his name, but the property didn't sell, still hasn't sold, and that agent is no longer associated as a co-listing agent, but that agent still gets interviews based on his association with that home. So I, again, believe the fastest way to get that instant credibility from your database, your sphere, people that didn't even know you were in real estate, it's eye candy. I hate to say it, but high-end and luxury homes, you'll get more clicks. And that's what number three talks about. Most people know ROI is what, Eric? Return on?
Investment.
Investment. But the second type of ROI is return on impression. I guarantee you, as an agent, you're going to get more clicks and more views when you post something on Facebook, just listed, or your just sold postcards that you guys send out around your database through Breakthrough Broker. You're going to get more clicks and more eyeball traffic on your high-end and luxury than your entry level. It's just a fact. It's no different than exotic cars. So the 7 benefits of selling high-end homes, it doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure out, number one, you earn higher paychecks unless you work for a flat fee company and you're an employee. Number two, you can be more profitable because it's called the slack adjuster. I just literally had a 2.195 sale last week, and you know, won't go into the details on the commission check, but let's just say it was over $40,000. That's a slack adjuster. That makes up for some lean months. Number three, better return on investment and impression. Number four, you're going to get better referrals. Number five, more time off, because again, if you make more money selling the same number of homes or maybe less, you can bring on an assistant. You can take more time off. I believe money freedom equals time freedom equals relationship freedom. Let me say that again. Money freedom equals time freedom equals relationship freedom. If you make more money, you can donate back. You can give to causes. It's not about being greedy. You can take more time off. You can do more things philanthropical, whatever it is. Number six is credibility and respect. And number seven, it's more fun. Now, Eric, I know a lot of the people on today are probably thinking, yeah, I'd like to sell more high-end and luxury homes, but, you know, but this or but that. I call those limiting beliefs or excuses. You don't have to be a top producer or have gray hair to be a luxury home. You personally don't need to be wealthy. You don't need to live in a large house in a gated community, drive a luxury exotic car, or be with a certain office. Or I can't compete. Look, yesterday I did a training for At Properties in Chicagoland, and I had an agent that said, well, there's four luxury agents in my community already. I said, that's it? Is my point is, that's it? You know, there's 40 something thousand agents in Illinois, and she's worried about four. Don't think of it that way. You got to know what makes you different as an agent. That's called a unique value proposition. You need to know what makes your office different, what makes you different. But again, there's so many limiting beliefs and misconceptions about selling high-end and luxury homes. And I'm here to tell you, don't be one of those agents. Now, I told you earlier, grow your knowledge and your confidence will grow. And you might say, well, Mike, that sounds great, but how do I grow my knowledge? Well, I'm glad you asked. Number one, you need to know the ins and the outs of your company. When I launched my luxury designation 4 years ago, it was to a RE/MAX office down in Dallas. Mark Wolf is the broker owner. And I had an agent come up to me at the end of the training. It was a full day training. She said, I got a luxury listing during the training today. And the agent told me who she was interviewing. It was another agent from this training, another RE/MAX agent. And she said, that agent only talked about RE/MAX, RE/MAX, RE/MAX. I talked about RE/MAX, but I also talked about number four here, which is what made me different and unique, my unique value proposition as an agent, what gave me the competitive advantage, what I did differently. So again, this is a tip for you as an agent. You need to know what makes your company different and unique, but you got to also have something different and unique about you. Most people are terrible. They don't like talking about themselves, or they don't like talking about their story. Well, I was a former high school teacher and a part-time agent, and I used that part of my story, how I can work with people of all different learning modalities, from backgrounds, the difficult people, you know, all that. That's good for when you're negotiating and working with other agents. So use your story and leverage it and bounce it off people and get their thoughts. But chances are everybody on this training has got a great story. So you need to know the numbers at your local market. That helped grow your confidence. You got to have people skills. You got to be likable. Theodore Roosevelt said, nobody cares how much you know until they know you care. Be more likable. Be authentic, by the way. Be yourself. Don't try to be something you're not. And then, of course, you need to have some, I hate to call them sales skills, but you need to, we are in sales. You got to be able to overcome objections and articulate and highlight the best features of a home. Be authentic. Be yourself, but these are ways that you can grow your knowledge. Now, I'm a big believer in having great visuals when you're sitting across from a potential client or a current client. So have great visuals in your marketing message, on your listing appointments, on your buyer presentations, on your website. Don't just have a bunch of bullet points and words. Now, again, you really need to understand this concept. And this is a slide from my friends over at Keeping Current Matters. You need to know what a buyer's market is, what a neutral market is, and what a seller's market is. And so that is defined many times in how many months of inventory there is. I mentioned earlier, I had a $2 million sale a week ago. There was over 6 years of inventory in Barrington Hills. Five homes had sold above $2 million. and yet they're 33 on the market. That's over 6 years of inventory. So you need to understand in your market, based on price point, it could shift. Maybe for the luxury homes that are three times the average sale price, it's a buyer's market. But for entry-level homes within your market, it's a seller's market. So you need to understand that, and you need to be able to articulate it, because there's nothing worse when you have a seller that says, man, I hear the market's hot, and you list his luxury home, but his home is in a buyer's market. So you got to understand the market, because no matter what kind of market you're in, it's like the pendulum. The pendulum shifts from a seller's market at some price point in your market to a balanced market over to a buyer's market. I had an agent out of Dallas, Texas that went through our training, Eric, and within 60 days, she called me and she had a $5.1 million listing. She would never feel comfortable going on a $1 million listing appointment for our training, but Joan went on a $5 million appointment after our training, and it's all about helping agents grow their knowledge. Now, let me give some good free ways for free, most powerful word in marketing, free. Let me give some free strategies for agents that can get in front of more high-end and luxury opportunities. Number one, sit and work other people's open houses in your office that have high-end and luxury listings. Number two, attend broker opens from other agents, whether they be in your office or not. As I mentioned earlier, I have a podcast, and I had a gentleman by the name of Amit Bhutta. He's a Compass agent out of Miami. His hashtag is the Indian agent or Indian realtor. But he broke into luxury by doing just this. He went to other people's broker opens that had high-end and luxury homes. He would do Facebook Live videos. He would get permission ahead of time. So he'd be like, hey, Eric, you got that listing, that broker open next week at 123 Elm Street. I'm planning on attending. Hey, Eric, would you have a problem if I did a Facebook Live video, but I would tag you as the agent and I'd put a property website in there if you give, you know, let me know what it is. And I'd make sure I wouldn't, you know, mislead. I wouldn't say it's my listing, but I'd try to provide more exposure. Would that be okay with you, Eric? Most Absolutely. People, of course, are going to say, yeah, not a problem. So those are two free nuggets I just gave you. Number one is work other people open house. Now you might be saying, what? Well, Mike, high-end and luxury homes don't sell at open houses because of, well, if that's the way you think, then you're probably right. But I'm here to tell you, even if you don't sell it directly at the open house, there's definitely a benefit. There's a Sotheby agent out of Scottsdale that she does weekly open houses on her $5, $7, $10 million plus listings. And she said, Mike, even if I have zero activity or zero qualified people that come through, the weeks I do open houses, I get more clicks and more views on my website, as well as the third party websites like Redfin and Zillow, et cetera. So I tell the sellers, I manage your expectation, Mr. and Mrs. Seller, even if nobody comes through the open house, it's not going to be a waste of my time or yours, because we're going to get more eyeball traffic. Mr. Seller, when we get more eyeball traffic, we get more clicks. When we get more clicks, we have a higher probability of qualified showings. So anyways, I could go on and on about this, but I wanted to talk about that. So let me talk to you about the 30% rule, because that's why you guys are on this training today, is you want to increase your average sale price. And that's really number three. Now, there's three ways you can make more money this year. Number one is sell more homes. Now, many of you might think, well, that's working harder. I don't want to work harder, but that's not necessarily the case. Maybe you, for every 10 listing appointments you go on, for example, you convert 6 out of 10 to a client, to a listing. Well, if we can increase your conversion through articulating better, by showing up different, by having great materials, by, you know, by building your track record, by growing your knowledge and your confidence, and you can land, let's say, 9 out of 10 in 2020, that's increasing your conversion, but that's working smarter, not harder. In that instance, you would get 3 more listings going on the same 10 appointments. Number two, increase what you charge. Now, I know what the Sherman antitrust law says. I'm not telling you what to charge, but what I am telling you is, if you bring more value to the table, that you shouldn't have to compete by discounting. And what I do know, Eric, is when people go into break into high-end and luxury, and the average sale price goes up for homes they represent, many agents that don't have the knowledge and the confidence and the track record, unfortunately, they compete by lowering their fee, and I don't want you to do that. And number three is increase your average sale price. This is what an increase of an average sale price of 30% would look like. If in your given market or your personally average sale price is 200,000, if we can get you to 260, that's a 30% raise. 300 to 390 is a 30% raise. 500,000 average sale price to 650 and so on. That is what a 30% raise. I know I can't see you raising your hand, but how many of you raise your hand would like at least a 30% raise over the next year or more?
I hope everyone on this call.
I hope so too, Eric. So why not you? Why can't we make you the success story? Now, maybe some of you have heard of Roger Bannister, but Roger Bannister was the person to run the first mile under 4 minutes. And do you realize that within 2 years, 37 others ran that same mile under 4 minutes? Do you know why? It wasn't because Nike came out with these new comfortable shoes or Gatorade came out with this energy drink. It was because of the mindset. And I know we're still on pillar number one, the mindset. You might be saying, Mike, I came here for some thingamajigger and all I'm learning about is mindset so far. And you're right, because the thought process was, if Roger could run that mile under 4 minutes, so can I. And 37 others did it within 2 years. So that's my point. If you don't believe you can break into high-end and luxury, you're right, but I'm here to tell you, you can. No matter what your background is, no matter what brand you're with, no matter how many years, if I were to go back to my younger self in 2000 when I got licensed in real estate, I would have told myself, don't wait 13 years to go selling luxury, do it now. So let's talk about the second pillar for today's training, and that's your marketing blueprint. So the first was building that foundation, the mindset, whether you think you can or you can't. You're right. So the mindset. The second pillar we're going to talk about is your marketing blueprint. Your marketing blueprint. The first rule of thumb of marketing is to grab people's attention, Eric. There's over 1.3 million realtors out there. Everybody knows a real estate agent. I challenge everybody on today's training not to think like a real estate agent, but to think like a marketer. There's a calculated difference. And when it comes to high-end and luxury, unfortunately, many people, just like Einstein, doing the same thing over and over again and expecting different results. I can attest that when I do these trainings all over the world, most that are in luxury are doing things like everybody else. And Einstein calls that insanity, because I can tell you the top 10% in most markets are a buyer's market. Now, if you saw the movie Robert De Niro was in called Meet the Parents, you might be saying to yourself, well, Mike, it's very difficult to penetrate the circle of trust. And guess what? You're right. It is. It's a lot easier if you came from wealth, or you went to that private school, or you were raised in that gated community, you know, that private community, and you know others in that community already. It's much easier. But I didn't come from that, and most don't. So don't worry about it. Check that excuse out the door. Now, the problem is in real estate in general is people don't trust us. They look at us as salespeople. This is from Reader's Digest some years ago. The most trusted professionals, and Eric, we came in at 35, just above sex workers. That's not good. So you need to know that people look at real estate agents as car salesmen. So you have to do everything possible to become that trusted advisor, to break down the barriers of the stereotypes of our industry, especially when it comes to high-end and luxury. The good news for you is there's a lot of traditional agents out there that think inside the box, and they're dinosauric in the way they think. They don't adapt to change, just like unfortunately Blockbuster and Toys R Us didn't adapt. And what happens is they're extinct. You need to always be adapting. So the most listened to radio station that your prospective client thinks it listens to, it's the same in Denver, it's the same in Chicago, it's the same in Dallas, where I'm going next week, speaking at the Keller Williams family reunion. It's what's in it for me. The default radio station that a prospective buyer you're going to be working with, or your current seller or potential seller, all they care about is, what are you going to do to save them time, aggravation, and make more money as a seller or for a buyer? What are you going to do to find me that off-market property so I can and get me the best deal possible? So the sooner you realize that, you're going to adapt your mindset, you're going to adapt your marketing effort, so you can attract more opportunities versus chase. Now, I get asked all the time, Mike, if you were to move to Denver or a new market, what would be some of the first couple things you would do to break into the luxury market and establish yourself as a rock star agent? Number one, I would create a luxury networking group, which I'll go into in a minute. Number two, I would invest in a mentor or join an office that sells high-end homes because of the instant credibility effect. And number three, I would do some prospecting and some lead generation. So I wish I had a little bit more time to kind of go into this, but this is kind of our blueprint and some ways you can do some lead generation is a luxury networking group. You can do events.
Take your time, Michael. We're good. Take your time. Okay. If you want to do a few of these.
All right, good. You could work for sale by owners. You could do canceled and expired. You could work with divorce sellers, estate sellers. You can do farming of communities. Eric's got a great tool with Breakthrough Broker. If you sell 123 Elm Street, you can do circle prospecting and do just sold or just listed postcards around there. Like within a day, they can get those sent out. Those are great tools and resources because many of you might only have a high-end listing. Well, then leverage that high-end listing as best you can. Do one of those videos with drones and actors and leverage that. Spend a lot more money, invest a lot more money on that first high-end listing and leverage it to attract other opportunities. The Chicagoland market is a cold market. We have years of inventory, and that's really why I do some things that are a little bit aggressive and outside the box. I do a lot of mailers. I do a lot of videos. Again, content marketing, you might have a blog. I do educational videos. I do a lot of Facebook marketing. These are all things you can do. I got to tell this quick story, Eric. Do you remember as a kid, show and tell?
Mm-hmm.
You were excited. It was your day to bring something and talk about it. You remember that?
I do.
Well, this is my son, Vinny the Bulldozer. It was a show and tell one day at his school, and we didn't realize it. And he was supposed to bring something with the letter M. And he brought Daddy's Moscow Mule mug. It's a copper mug that has Tito's embranded on the side. He thought he scored a trifecta because it was three M's. Luckily, Miss Carson had a sense of humor and the DCFS wasn't called. But think about show and tell. We are in a show and tell industry, aren't we? Real estate, we're basically in a Tinder industry. People are going to swipe left on your listing or swipe right. And so a picture is worth 1,000 words. Maybe somebody in your office had a record sale. Well, ask them, hey, Johanna, I see you had a record sale at 123 Elm Street. Would you mind if I posted about it and I tagged you? If you don't have your own success stories, leverage other people's success stories until you have your own. So these are examples of Polaroids. Remember the old Kodak camera, the Kodak pictures, the Polaroids? Mm-hmm. Like these are all examples, record sales, sold above appraisal. I'm just giving you some examples because you guys need to be able to leverage your record sales. Maybe you had a record sale and it's the highest sale in 2020. Well, you might chuckle because you say, here we are in February. But leverage it. Most people don't read. They just see record sale. So leverage your little victories and then leverage other people on your team or your office's victories until you have your own success stories. I would work cancel and expireds if I were you. Okay. Those are low hanging fruit. But I would also start a luxury networking group. I would join a chamber in an area that services high net worth, you know, community, high net worth individuals. I'd join that chamber and eventually I'd break off and start my own networking group. And I wish I could spend an hour on this, but your networking group, basically you meet once a month. The prerequisite, these are some benefits of you, the CEO of your Lux networking group, is you're the connector. I believe the best way to get referrals is give referrals. So these are some of the benefits, and the right bullet points could be some of the people on your actual webinar. So that is some of the benefits. This is one of the first things I would do if I were to break in a new market, Eric, is I would join the chamber, build relationships, either stay a member of the chamber, and in addition to start my own networking group. And this is kind of what it looks like. You know, you have 12 months in a year, you meet monthly, three or four times a year. You host them at your luxury listings, and the other eight or nine events you host at other people in the group that have a cool business, something that's fun, so people look forward to it. You share best practices. You go around, you introduce yourself. Hi, my name is Mike. I'm a luxury real estate agent with XYZ Realty. My ideal client is a buyer or seller. What's really working in my business? Number two, that's what everybody shares, what's really working in your business. Because some of my best ideas, Eric, are outside of the real estate industry. And so don't think of it. Why would I want to know what what's really working in this guy's business or hers or his? Because the best ideas, I believe, are not the same things that everybody else is doing in your industry. They're different ideas outside of the industry, which you bring in, you tweak and mold and make it your own. And number three would basically be who you use help with, who you need help with. So that's basically what the introductions consist of there, Eric. And so everybody goes around and they say who they are, what's working in their business, what they're struggling with. And so when everybody goes around and at the end, you bring everybody together and you say, hey guys, make sure you exchange cards. There's some great practices in this group. We're still gonna be giving tours of the home. There's some food in the kitchen, and I'm gonna be sending out an email, save the date reminder for next month's meeting. And the prerequisite for everybody in the group is they're high integrity business owners. They do what they say they're going to do. They're hungry. They want to grow their business. And their client, their ideal client, is a high net worth individual. And so here's some pictures of some amazing locations. This was at our Bentley Lamborghini dealership. And I have a client, he's got our designation. He's one of the co-founders of EXP Realty. And within our training, he incorporated our best practices. He put together, Eric, a $10,000 event at a $6.5 million listing that we helped him secure. And he got it all paid through sponsorships. So again, if you grow your knowledge, you grow your confidence, you grow your network, you can put together some amazing events. So again, to review, number one, we talked about the foundation, which is your mindset and surrounding yourself with great environment and great resources. Number two, we talked about what are some ways you can attract more opportunities. Work other people's open houses, go to other people's broker open their tours. You could start your own networking group, build your database, okay? Leverage other people's successes in your offices. Number three, let's talk about positioning power. I only have about 3 minutes left here before we open up for Q&A, but positioning power is basically, I gave you one already, video. Leveraging other people's broker opens is a positioning power. Remember, you're not in the real estate business. You're in the business of marketing your real estate business. Eric, would you rather have an amazing website that nobody goes to or have a decent website that gets a ton of traffic?
Obviously, the traffic.
The traffic, right? So I'm a recovering perfectionist. I am a micromanager on certain aspects of my business, but good is good enough in certain aspects of your business. But you need to let everybody know that you're in the business of selling real estate, because there's nothing worse when you log on to Facebook and you see somebody just listed their home, and guess what? They didn't list with you because they forgot that you were in the business or you didn't stay in touch with them. So I challenge everybody on this training to get out of your comfort zone, because that is where the magic happens. This is your comfort zone, step out of it. So video is one of the ways I'm challenging everybody on this training to do video. And there's ways you can do free video, Eric, and there's ways that you can invest in video. But I'm here to tell you that video is the new gold standard when it comes to selling high-end homes and average priced homes for that matter. And there's ways you can do video for free through Facebook Live or Instagram Live, etc. There's four main reasons you want to use video. One, differentiate yourself. Two, you build trust, which helps boost conversion. Excuse me. Number three, Google loves video. Hello, YouTube is owned by Google. And number four, buyers and sellers want it. So you could do Facebook Lives. For example, this was a house that was rumored that Kanye West was going to be buying in Naperville, Illinois, that I represented. I did a Facebook Live with a coming soon video. Basically, hey, sneak peek at my $7 million listing. There's my photographer in the background. Within 24 hours, Eric, we had 1,200 views on this free video. Now, do you know what the average YouTube video has? How many views they have on average, Eric?
I don't.
400. Do People will spend $1,000, $500 on videos, and the average video has 400 views on YouTube.
Wow.
I got 1,200 views for free. So put educational videos out there, tips for buyers, tips for sellers, market update. How are home prices in Denver in February of 2020 doing compared to February of 2019? So educational tips for buyers, tips for sellers, and market updates. So you could do case studies as well. Maybe how you sold a home where another agent couldn't do it. So I did a lifestyle video on this home where we shot video from a helicopter. It was a $2 million sale. After we sold it, we did a video from it saying the train house sold. We got 1,000 views, 986 within a day, just telling people how we got the home sold. We sat down with the owner. She shared it. So my challenge for everybody is to create a YouTube account. I did a training yesterday for about 30 agents at Ad Properties. Not one person raised their hand as having a YouTube account. Create a YouTube channel for free. All you need is a Gmail account. You can just create a Gmail account just for your YouTube channel and then put content up there. I challenge you to put a video once a month up there for tips for buyers and another video up there for tips for sellers. So that would be 24 videos in February of 2021 if you consistently put two out a month. If you want to put a third out, put a market update, February update, a March update. And now you'd have three a month or 36 at the end of a year. You want to do some property videos. I brought in $2.5 million worth of vehicles, Eric, for free. This was a relationship through my networking group. They let me borrow 7 cars. They brought them up and we shot this video at this property. When you create a property and a video, you want to have an amazing thumbnail. A thumbnail is the image of the video before you hit the play button. This is my Facebook Live video with those exotic cars coming up. We had 7 exotic cars, so be prepared when you're doing these videos. I was shooting a Facebook Live while the vehicles were pulling in. I leveraged videos because one of the things that agents get with our designation, we include a video brochure. We upload some videos to this brochure, so when they go on a listing appointment, Eric, they're differentiating themselves. So the action steps over the next 90 days, my challenge for everybody is number one, choose today to be focused on how I can increase my average sale price. How can I do more in the high end and the luxury space? Again, high end is two times the average sale price for your given market, and luxury is 3 times. So you have to be purposeful about it. You have to be focused on it. You have to write your goals down. You got to have visuals. Otherwise, it's not going to happen. Number two, you need to get the prospect's attention. You need to break in with the influencers. How can you do that? Attend other broker opens. Go to the chamber meetings. You have to get outside of your comfort zone. There's an adage out there that I say all the time, Eric, shy real estate agents have skinny kids. You can't be shy in this industry. You got to talk to people. You got to bring business cards. You got to step outside your comfort zone. Number three, you got to know the numbers inside and out. You got to really own your numbers. And you might not memorize them, but you understand, is it a buyer's market? Is it a seller's market? You got to really own the numbers. Number three, you got to create unique experiences on your listings or for your buyers. You got to build relationships with trusted advisors, and you have to listen to some things that I'm about to share with you. Number one, we are in an election year. I can't stress this enough. You have to remember both Democrats, Republicans, and for that matter, independents buy and sell large houses. You got to keep politics off Facebook. Otherwise, you're going to divide and you're going to dismiss half of your database in your sphere. I'm not going to mention a name, but one of the leading luxury brands out there in real estate, the person that runs their luxury division is always, he's an anti-Trumper. He's always posting stuff. Whether you like the guy or you are an anti-Trumper, you're dismissing half of your database. And if you hang out with 9 top producers, I believe you're bound to be a 10th. As I mentioned to you, this is the gentleman that we launched our luxury division to. I want to just share with you a couple things. This is my contact information. If you want to connect with me, You can check out our website, Luxury Listing Specials. If you want more information about our actual designation, I'm going to share that with you right now, and then we're going to open it up for 15 minutes of Q&A. Our designation, Eric, is 16 modules. There's over 10 and a half hours of video content. It's online, although we teach live trainings, most people do it online. We give everybody the directions step by step. These are the actual modules. The first 7 modules are what I like to call pre-listing. How do you attract more listings? Mindset, marketing, best video practices, how to convert more appointments to listings. How do you differentiate yourself? We talked about this, Eric. How do you send a shock and awe package if you have an appointment tomorrow? How do you send something to them, to their house, that they're pre-sold on you? That's what we talk about in Module 6, either digitally or physically. Module 7, we talk about best practices on the actual listing presentation. I won't bore you with the details on Module 8 through 16, but bottom line, you got that difficult listing, that high-end listing, that luxury listing. Great. What the heck are you going to do to get it sold? So for anybody that's interested, Eric, they can go there. I throw in a bunch of bonus items for your audience. They can go to that URL, luxurylistingspecials.com/silver. If they just go to luxurylistingspecials.com, they can buy online, but they're not going to get the bonus items that we're offering your audience, including the video brochure. For anybody that signs up, we'll throw in a video brochure with an endorsed message from me. We give you the directions step by step, so you can charge the video brochure right down here. You can upload your own videos, or you can leverage ours till you have your own. I'll also throw in what I call my $1 million mailer, which is for cancel and expired. And we also have a mystery. So anyways, they can go there, but let's open it up for Q&A, Eric.
Absolutely. So we have a couple questions. What is the benefit of getting a designation?
Well, it's just like anything else. It's how do you leverage it, right? So I believe Jack Trout wrote a book called Differentiate or Die. I think somebody else once said differentiate or charge less. So what are you doing to differentiate yourself? There's a lot of ABC letters behind a lot of real estate agents' names, and they don't mean Jack unless you can leverage them, unless you explain to the seller, Mr. and Mrs. Seller. Most real estate agents are trained in real estate school of one size fits all. And so I actually have a specific designation, best practices to sell high-end and luxury homes, because guess what? It is a buyer's market, Mr. Seller. There's 4 months of inventory. There's 6 months of inventory, or whatever it might be. So it's not just the designation, Mr. and Mrs. Seller, but it's all that comes with it. I belong to a private Facebook group. So if I have a listing that's not getting showings and activity, or your home, I could post it to the group and get feedback from the group. I have a Rolodex of top luxury agents that have relationships internationally. So that when we build these relationships, Mr. Seller, we have a higher probability of not only using best practices to get your home sold, but also giving you the exposure it needs. So it's not a designation, that's not what's going to get more clients, Eric. It's leveraging it, being able to articulate it. And actually, just like Breakthrough Broker, I guarantee you there's tons of agents that don't even know all the benefits that they could be leveraging from Breakthrough Broker. And so that's what we try to do with our onboarding, is we want to make sure agents know all the benefits. It's not just a logo that you can use in your print and digital. It's the relationships. It's a network.
One of the things I wanted to touch on, so I have a question. There are a few other questions here. As you were going through analyzing your home sales, so you had that slide where it showed, you know, you did 5 or 6 in one of the buckets and 4 in another bucket.
Yes.
When you look at that in the past year, do you analyze? I got to thinking, so if I sold 4 in the high end bucket, I might go back and look at how did I get those 4 listings and double down on that, either advertising or referral network or whatever. Is that something that you would agree with?
Yeah, so you're always SWOT analysis, right, Eric? So, you know, when just like at Breakthrough Broker, it's 2019, you know, was ending up, you're looking back, hey, what could we have improved? What could we do better? What are we going to put for initiatives in 2020? It's no different. So one of the things we do is we help independents and brokers launch luxury divisions that don't have them, or we help the individual agents. So when you look at the buckets that you represented homes you sold last year, again, entry level or starter home bucket, average price bucket, high end, which is 2 times your average sale price, or luxury, you need to assess, like, are you happy with your average sale price? If you're content and you're happy with what you're doing, then keep, of course, doing it. But if there's something that you say to yourself, well, yeah, I could have been a little bit more focused on some high end, or made myself available to go to some more of these networking meetings in those zip codes I don't do much business in, you know, so that's something that Empire Home, for example, that $9.5 million listing I have on the listing appointment, he point blank asked me, how many homes have you sold in Barrington Hills, Illinois? I said, I haven't sold any. Now, that one I sold last week was my first, but I told him, I haven't sold any, but if you're looking for a neighborhood expert, you've interviewed a couple neighborhood specialists before and they didn't get the home sold. If you're looking for somebody that's aggressive and thinks outside the box, you're talking to the right guy. So again, if you don't have luxury sales, leverage others in your network, leverage your brand, your brokerages, maybe somebody else on your team. If you don't have any of those people, then leverage your network if you do have some kind of designation.
Awesome. A couple things. So for house cleaning, I'm going to put Michael on the spot. Michael, I'd love for you to write or do a few videos for us over 2020 with some micro topics. Would you be willing?
Absolutely. I have 16 micro topics. Well, I could spend an hour on all day, these or others, of course.
So in addition to that, I want to announce to everybody that we're going to be doing Breakthrough Broker's first online designation series. We're going to work with Michael to give you guys this class through Breakthrough Broker webinars. We'll be doing, I think we're going to do a 2-day, right, Michael? And yeah, it'll be over 2 days. It'll be live web-based, and it'll be the ability to get this designation and join the group. And we're looking forward to trying this through Breakthrough Broker. We've never done it before with our users. So if you're looking to, it's one thing, guys, that Nathan and I, when we were selling, really wished we did. We really stuck to our wheelhouse, and we worked really hard in our average price range to sell a lot of homes to make the money we wanted to make. We would have been much better served to try and go out and get a better average sales price to break into a higher end or luxury marketplace, because with our work ethic, we would have doubled, tripled, quadrupled our money, but we probably could have spent more time, you know, with our family. So, guys, this is passionate for me. We have to end here. Michael, we'll invite you back.
Real quick. The biggest thing, Eric, is with our designation, we have zero sales requirements. So if you've never sold a luxury home, or like others out there that require 3 sales in the last 24 months, we don't have that as a requirement, because I want to raise the bar in the industry. And so if an agent gets that first opportunity, that first trophy listing, we want them to have the tools to be successful versus, hey, good luck and come back to us and when you have 3 sales. That's not us.
Awesome. Well, thank you. And we will stay connected. And everybody, thanks for being on this call. Michael, I can't thank you enough. It's awesome that you give your time to our community like that. Everybody, the recording of this will be sent out this afternoon once my team gets it processed and we're all ready to rock and roll. Again, Michael, thank you. The recording will go out, and everybody, thanks for joining us today.
Thanks, Eric.